American reporters, perhaps they're more interested in Esperanto or the Baha'i movement than the European reporters. You see, I'm most unfashionably thin to make the headlines in Europe. Perhaps if I were a bit more plump, I would be taken more seriously.
New York Sun.
Guten Tag.
Let's have that again.
Guten Tag.
Are you speaking in Esperanto?
Yes. Guten Tag means good day.
Could you repeat that slowly for us uninformed reporters?
Of course. Guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
Very good. You will make excellent Esperanto students.
Mrs. Quinlan over there informs us that all you Esperanto speakers wear little green stars on your lapel, so you can recognize each other.
Yes, that's correct.
Well, I was wondering if you could teach us how to say a few things, just in case we run into somebody wearing one of your little green stars.
Why, certainly, sir. What would you like to say in Esperanto?
How about, I love you?
$5.
Yeah, that's a sure way of letting to see how much brotherly love Esperanto has created amongst its speakers.
Just speaking of that, how old are you?
What?
How tall are you? Are you on a special diet?
Do you have any boyfriends? And if yes, does he play baseball or football?
I have no time for such foolishness.
If you don't have time for boyfriends, no wonder you're so skinny.
Let me ask you this. Isn't it true that the Minister of Education in Germany, Bernard Rust, decreed that Esperanto weakens essential values of national character?
And isn't it true that the propaganda minister, Joseph Goebbels, found Esperanto inconsistent with the aims of Nazi nationalism and asked the Esperanto Association in Germany to dissolve themselves?
How is that true that the head of the Gestapo, Reinhard Heydrich, objected to the fact that Esperanto's founder was a Jew?
And isn't it true that the SS chief, Heinrich Himmler, outlawed Esperanto in Germany?
And isn't it true that all of this is because Adolf Hitler wrote in his book, Mein Kampf, that Esperanto was part of a Jewish conspiracy to take over the world?
Yes, yes,
that's about all I need.
What?
If I could just have a picture of you with your toy animals.
That's right, your toy animals. We were informed that you teach Esperanto using toy animals.
Yes, but you haven't asked me anything yet.
Says the lady.
Uninformed reporters are unable to respond since they don't speak any Esperanto. Berlin Tegan, a slender young woman, I'd say darn right skinny, wearing spectacles, greeted a somewhat startled group of reporters.
And thus the fourth estate was introduced to the international language by its principal advocate, Miss Lidia Zamenhof, younger daughter of its late founder.
After demonstrating that she could speak English, Miss Zamenhof laughs back into Esperanto, and there she stayed for the remainder of the interview, despite much coaxing by the reporters.
And when questioned, do you have any boyfriends? Miss Zamenhof replied, no, haven't time for such foolishness.